tensions building. All around, you can feel it in the air. It's more than a feeling. A new reality everywhere. I look to see the signs of the times. Yeah, it's coming, but they're all in denial. Everything you know, it's all about to change. See the sky crack and it rains down flames. Oh man, they ain't ready for it. This is something that they can't ignore. Coming down like a meteor. This is more than a game. You better get ready. Shock the world.
Shock the world.
Shock the world. This is more than a game. You better get ready.
Is a early morning here from Texas. Team Colorado, Team Arizona Copper. Going after it here on an early morning, 7:07 here in Texas, 5:07 back home in State 48, Arizona. Team AZ Copper 2-0 in the early going with two wins yesterday, one against California, one against Team Indiana. As we go through this one, two more games on the schedule today for Team Copper, two more games on the schedule today for Team Black. We'll have four streams for you today, all here on the Asha YouTube page, all games today, and we'll see what tomorrow brings. But game three of the weekend for Team Arizona Copper, puck has dropped and we're off. Colorado in blue, Team Arizona in their maroon, as Quinar is on the forecheck. Austin Chartle in net for Team Arizona Copper this morning, with Logan Hunter, the goalie for Team Colorado. Quiner gets on the puck, past Bouchard, finds Kane, who shoots, he put it high. Tried to go high glove on Hunter, and he got the back glass. This line of Flynn, Kane, and Quiner has been excellent so far this weekend. A line that's forechecked well, and Flynn is making me look good when he does just that, taking the puck away. Flynn over to Shane Eirelson at the top of the circle. He puts it toward the net, and it just went past the far post, and Kara Hella will go and chase after it. First shift down here on a long day and early morning. Two games in the morning as icing's waved off. Quinar got a piece, and two games later at night. We got a full schedule, a full slate of games today here in Dallas. Stockert's trying to push it forward for Colorado. Wilkerson will get to Stockert, who backhands it in. Austin Chartle played the second game yesterday, the one against Team Indiana. He had two goals, a few big saves, especially in the third period when Team Indiana started to have a little bit of a push there with about 8 minutes to go. Welch can't pick it up. Bartow pushed it to neutral. And here comes Copper right back in the zone. Kudakov. Sneed Putikov pushed off the puck, comes right back to it. Gets it past Cannonberg. Stepien turned it over. And Colorado's Bendico will push it forward. This one's offside as Stockert went in, but his teammate to his left went in a little bit too early. It's about 2 minutes in here in the first period. Hunter, the goalie, left-handed glove for Colorado, and Chartle for Team Arizona Copper. We'll see Logan Gibbs most likely in the second game today. He played the first game yesterday against Team California in a 6-4 win for Team Arizona Copper. They've been 2-0. They've scored 11 goals, with only one being an empty netter from Maffeo last night. They've been very impressive and then some. And this line has led everything. Here is Jim over the line. On the left wing, Jim trying to cut toward the net. He'll go behind. Jim, McCaughey, and Gramlich. The three forward set as Jim toes the blue line. Down low, shot taken, save. McCaughey was there for the rebound and it comes out the other side. Newsham's taken down, no call, as it, Copper will come back to the neutral zone. First shot on net for Team Arizona. An easy save for Logan Hunter, and McCaughey was there trying to poke in the rebound. Ryan McCaughey with a goal in each game so far. In this showcase, Reed Gramlich the same way. Ryan Jim with 4 points, a goal and three assists. They've carried the heavy lifting, but it just hasn't been, it hasn't been just them. It's been truly all four lines that have made an impact for Team Arizona so far today. We get an arm up from the official as it was touched by a high stick, and they'll bring the faceoff to the offensive zone for Team Arizona. Jim. First chance for Butler, Maffeo to get on the ice. Back to the blue line. Maffeo will chase it down low. Ripley in the corner for Colorado. Can't get it past Eirilson. Does a good job trying to feed the slot. Stepien, Butler, and Maffeo, the three forward set. We saw Stepien yesterday a little bit on that fourth line with Welch along with McCutcheon. See what head coach Kenny McGinley has in store today as Eirilson tries to toss it toward the net. He'll get his own rebound and backhand it forward down. Butler tips it in. Tatum for Colorado, can't exit the zone. A good offensive zone shift here from Team Arizona. No shots yet. Let's see if Maffeo can change that. He's in the circle now, dodging toward the goal line. Backhand pass, Stepien can't pull the trigger. And then he does, and it's blocked. Good play from Ripley on the back check. Rahela toward the net, he put it wide to the far side. Kept in by Eirilson. He'll go down to the goal line, trying to toss it in front. Butler was there. A long offensive zone shift for Maffeo, Butler, and Stepien. This one, the icing waved off. And tossed all the way to Stepien, who's going to tip it in. Full change for Team Arizona. They get five new skaters. Barreto back for Colorado. Fanned on the pass. Jumping up to get it is Brady Engler. Engler has Kane in front, tries to feed him. Taken off his stick as Ward came back just in time to take away the one-time opportunity from Kane right in front of the net. 3-1, Arizona leads in shots. Still scoreless here, about 5 minutes in to period number one. Loose puck in neutral, picked up by Kane. Trying to get it was Kwinar. Flynn couldn't poke it out. Kwinar will toss it off the boards. It unfortunately hits the official, and it comes back the other way for Colorado. Chartle pushed it to the corner. Englert uses the glass. Bouncing puck somehow kept in from Colorado at the blue line. Barreto tried to toss it toward the net. And here comes Team Arizona. The other way, a 2-on-1. If they can get it, Kwinar toward the net. He got a stick on it, but right into the pad of the goalie, Hunter. Kane backhands it down, looking for Cooper Flynn. Barreto and Flynn go down in the corner. And the breakout pass is complete to Jackson. Jackson with a nice move to his backhand will go over the Arizona blue line. Toss it toward the net. Chartle pokes it behind, comes right back in front. And on the near side was Ward trying to snap it in. Got taken off his stick. Engler fighting for it. He turns it over. Backhand pass in front. Bouncing puck in the slot. Right off the bench is Wilkerson, and he puts his shot high. Jackson can't get it past Flynn. His second try. He dives down. 3-on-1 rush for Arizona the other way. Onside play over the line, and Switchenberg's shot got deflected off of Jordan's stick and wide. You're going to see Andrew Switchenberg definitely jump in on odd man rushes when he can. Not only is he a great defenseman, but has a lot of offensive power to him. This is offside as Switchenberg's high school teammate Ethan Niles comes back to get the whistle. Six minutes into the first period. What's been so impressive about Team Copper's offensive ability has been they can get high danger chances, and every line has done that, but their ability to forecheck and cycle the puck, which really tires out the opposing defenders, the opposing forwards, when you have 45-second minute shifts down low. Pudikov, Welch tries to put it on the backhand. He put it high of Hunter's shoulder and high of the crossbar at that as well. Niles pokes it out to the far side. Right over the line, Welch takes it on his stick. Quick shot, went wide and through the crease. Colorado will break it out the other way with a two-pass system. Get it up to Cannonberg, who will go right over the blue line, through one, through two, off of his stick. Milstein pushes his man to the corner in the far side. Colorado cycles the zone. Cannonberg puts it down deep. Looking for Stockert, taken away, and Copper comes out with it. Loose puck onside. Welch will have to go and chase after Adams. Adams drives the wall. Pudikov lays a big hit. 2-on-2 the other way. Turns into a 2-on-1. Only D back is Niles. Pass across to the forehand, and they score. Steven Cannonberg with the first marker of the day. Just about halfway through the first period, Colorado leads 1-0. Saw the 2-on-1 rush take place. And right to the forehand, as Schartl got aggressive and went to the top of his crease, Cannenberg did a good job of stopping on a dime and depositing it in the back of the net. So a very slick play on the two-on-two rush as Copper's D-man, it looked like Milstein, came down to the blue line looking to pinch in. They poke it forward, two-on-one rush. And here comes Gramlich with speed, looking to tie the game. Gramlich backhand, he scores! Just 14 seconds after Colorado takes a 1-0 lead, Reed Gramlich comes back to tie us up. It's been the quick strike capability for this Copper team that has been so impressive. Gramlich goes to the backhand, Hunter had no chance, and the speed and the response time, just 14 ticks after Colorado's goal, ties us up at one. That's Gramlich's third goal of the weekend, his fourth point. Tipped in, Bendico comes back, and that was at the start of their shift. Gramlich came really right off the bench as Welch and Stepien's line came off after the goal. Gramlich, McCaughey, and Jim, not a bad line to put out there if you're looking for a goal, and well, they answer right away. So Gramlich gets the goal. They give Rahela the assist on the Gramlich goal. Weston McCorkle goes out for it. Jordan will come back on D for Colorado. McCaughey comes back on D, takes it away. And McCorkle will flip it in. Right back out to the blue. Jackson shot, he scores! Three goals in exactly 60 seconds. Two from Team Colorado. And Logan Jackson gets this one, the defenseman wrist shot from the blue line over the shoulder of Schartl, and 2-1 Colorado in front. Jackson was the first one in line. It looked like there was definitely a lot of traffic in front. Schartl didn't get a clean look at it. Nobody touched it. Jackson gets credit for it. And Colorado up 2-1, looking for some quick strike again. Maffeo stops across, looking for Putikov, and Butler put it high. Maffeo taken down, tripping is going to be the call. Maybe it might not be a goal to come back right away, but drawing a penalty, that's a really good shift from the Maffeo, Butler, and Putikov line. As they get right in, Butler gets a high danger chance, misses the net, but Maffeo draws the tripping call against Team Colorado. It's going to be Parker Jordan heading to the box and a power play, Team Arizona. Shorthanded chance the other way, 2-on-1. Tristan Ward put it high. Another odd man rush for Colorado, this time down a man. And Team Arizona dodges a major bullet. The power play unit is Stepien, Jim, Gramlich, McCaughey, with Switchenberg at the top, as and Jim puts it in the back of the net. What a shot by Ryan Jim. Before you can even get set, Jim goes post and in on the far side over the blocker of Hunter. 2-2, another quick response. This time 48 seconds after Team Colorado went up 2-1, 2-2 the score. Ryan Jim led the team in points coming in. That's his second goal of the weekend. We've seen his shot at Desert the past 4 years, and it's gotten better and better. That time, Logan Hunter basically had no chance. It was the perfect spot for Jim to put it, right off the rush, into the circle, and Jim puts it in the back of the net. 2-2 the score. The offense has definitely woken up this morning. Defense, still a little bit groggy as we go through the first. So a power play goal for Ryan Jim. Another man advantage marker for the Team Arizona squad. Caught up in neutral ice. Borchard can't put it forward. Niles will come back with Milstein. Tipped ahead, Maffeo over the line. Switchenberg gets the assist on the Jim power play goal. Switchenberg with the assist. He gets the extra helper. Rahela had the assist on the first goal from Reed Gremlin. 2-2 with 5 minutes to go in period number one. Budakov across the line. This is the line that really set up. As Niles is offside, it just came out. 2-1 Colorado after that 2-on-1 rush. And then the shot from the blue line that went through from Jackson. You draw the penalty, you get your best guys back on the ice with a man advantage, and it pays off with Ryan Jim putting it in the back of the net. Quick response on both goals from Team Arizona. They went down 1-0. They come back just 14 seconds later, and now a penalty against Team Arizona for a tripping call. And we'll see what they have. Quinar was there along with the defenseman Niles. And it seems like he's the one that's going to head to the box. And it is. So Kyle Rahela is the one, actually, for tripping. First time to the power play for Team Colorado today. Jim made good on his power play opportunity. We'll see what Colorado can do. Jackson's at the top. He has that one goal. Big slap shot chance goes wide. Shartle possibly got a piece. Cannonberg on the circle. He puts it high, giving it to Stockert. Jackson at the blue. Down low. Cannonberg's one-timer went wide. Back out to Wilkerson. Colorado doing a good job of setting it up. They're keeping it into the circles. Now looking to go all the way across for Wilkerson was Cannonberg. Stockert at the half wall. Down to Cannonberg, looking to feed the slot and clear it all the way down from Cooper Flynn. Flynn and Quinar are the forward set as Flynn will head to the bench and get a change. Switchenberg and Brady Engler, the 2D. Cannonberg uses the wall, pass to Bayo. Can puts it on. That's it by Shartle. Rebound chance was swiped out of the slot before Colorado could put it in the back of the net. 1 minute gone in the penalty against Kyle Rahela for tripping. Jackson behind his own net puts it all the way across. Wilkerson will pass the red and rim it in. Niles back. Short glass makes him pay as it hits the netting. And the faceoff will come right back to the right of Austin Shartle. Three periods of 15-minute action here in the Lone Star Showcase with only a 1 minute intermission. So don't go anywhere once the period is over. It'll be just about 60 ticks of the clock as Switchenberg goes down in the corner before we get going for the next period. We go back to back twice today. As the loose puck, Maffeo's all alone on the breakaway. Shorthanded Nick Maffeo to the forehand save from Hunter. He gets the left pad in the way and saves a breakaway chance. Shorthanded for Maffeo. He was free from the red line in, and now he's doing some important killing on the penalty kill. Budakov puts it back. Niles, his shot goes high and into the glove of Hunter, which draws a whistle and a faceoff in the offensive zone for Team Arizona. 3 seconds until Rahela comes out of the box in a 2-2 game. Rahela stands in the small penalty box right next to the Team Arizona bench, right where the scorekeeper stands. McCaughey wins it back, and we're back to even strength. Great assistant coach Austin Rauer working the penalty box today. Also coaching the Team Arizona Black team as well. Cannonberg goes around the net, feeds it down low, clearing attempt kept in at the blue line just barely, and now it comes out as Adams couldn't hold it. Tatum goes across, working in the neutral zone as Team Colorado. Jim fanned on his first pass, now backhands it all the way across, gets it right back. A quick give and go, takes a hit as he gets it in deep. Tatum back on the forehand. McCaughey forces the puck. to Gramlich. He kicks it to his stick. Gramlich turns in the corner and lost it to Adams. We will try the near side wall. Niles does a good job of keeping it in. It goes over the stick of McCaughey. Tatum will try the near side with Cannonberg. Gets it ahead for Stockert. Kept in at the blue. Milstein puts a soft shot into the pad of Hunter. Gramlich takes a hit from Stockert. They go to battle in the corner. Backhanded to the half wall. McCaughey keeps it in. Gramlich on the backhand. Now turns to the forehand. Gramlich to McCaughey. They play give and go. Back to McCaughey. He's cutting toward the net. Got broken up, and Cannonberg will put it right back out to neutral ice where Milstein will hold it. 1:05 to go here in the first. A good shift from that first line. Well, really, if you're the opposing team, you have to think about, hey, we didn't allow any shots. Yeah, it wasn't a long shift in the offensive zone, but you always have to consider that a win with how good Gramlich, McCaughey, and Jim are together. Stepien down below the net, looking for Welch. Taken out of harm's way from Colorado, and the stick from Milstein blocks a breakaway pass for Cannonberg into the netting. Here at the Plano Rink in Dallas, the glass behind both goals of course, very tall, and the usual height requirement, but every other piece of glass is very short. They have a lot of netting here as well. This isn't like the ice den, where you can see right onto the ice. The netting here is black. Probably not great for the attendance, as it can block your view a little bit. Stepien shot off of Jordan and into the corner. Jackson will backhand it to the half wall. Stepien gives it right back with 15 ticks left on the clock. Almost turned over to Welch as it comes back out to neutral ice, and Switchenberg will turn with it. He turns one way, he turns the other way, and gets it in deep. That will take us to the end of period number one, and a period that had two goals apiece. The offense has come to play early this Saturday morning. Cannonberg started off for Colorado, then Reed Gremlich tied it up just 14 seconds later. Jackson with the goal to make it 2-1 from the shot from the blue line, and Ryan Jim with a power play goal to tie us up at 2, which is where we stand. We'll be right back for period number 2 here from Dallas, Texas. Back for period number 2 here from Dallas. We switch sides. Now the period of the long change as Flynn, Quinar, and Kane come out to start the period. For Team Copper, that scored twice but also allowed 2 goals. They lead 8-5 in shots after 1. Only one power play for each team in that first frame. Team Arizona was successful, Team Colorado was not. Comes back out to Jordan, whose shot gets deflected up and into the netting to start this period off. Colorado took a 1-0 lead, gave it right back 14 seconds later, and then took a 2-1 lead and gave it right back 48 seconds later. One from the even strength variety of Reed Gramlich's breakaway, a backhand chance. And then the second of a power play goal. This also happened yesterday as Jim comes right back onto the ice. Had to get some equipment fixed up. happened yesterday against Team California. They took a 2-1 lead on a power play goal. As Flynn puts it ahead, Jackson gives it right back. And after the goal, in the celebration, Team California, as this one's played by my hand pass, they took an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty, and Team Arizona made them pay with a power play goal. That's where the game changed, and then it went from 2-2 with the power play goal, 3-2, 4-2. Final score was 6-4. That fourth goal was a 6-on-3 power play goal. You don't see that a lot. Two-man up advantage, and then Team California also pulled their goalie. The only time in hockey you can have a three-man advantage, 6-on-3. Of course, 5-on-2 never happens, and probably for a good reason. I think it's a little too easy for the offense if you have a three-man advantage. And well, Team California made it look easy, and how could they not? Every rebound chance, there's a good chance that you have a skater there. Maffeo gives it right back to his D. Rahela, who took the penalty for tripping in the first period and also got an assist on the first goal from Gramlich. He'll come back and give it right back to Barlow, who tried to put it into the slot. Jordan back on D for Colorado. Tipped in by Ward. Back goes Rahela into the far side corner. He'll try the near side, as looking ahead of him was Butler, but couldn't control. Looked like he had just too much ice ahead of him, and he was already looking for the breakaway pass. Butler has to get onside. Sepien was all alone, but Butler laid out his man in front of the Arizona bench and went down as well as he laid the hit. So offside the call there. Just about a minute 40 into period number two. Seen some new line combinations as well, as everything's been working so far for Team Arizona, but also you want to see players play with different players. Stepien and Welch have been together, and now Flynn takes that spot. 2-on-1 the other way. Welch and Flynn. Welch on the far side puts it across. His pass was taken off his stick from Bendico. Flynn lays a big hit behind the net. Barreto will try the near side wall. It pops up, and they're going to say that either hit the ceiling or it was a high stick. The ceiling here is not high. It's not Oceanside Ice Arena low, if you remember the great Oceanside Ice Arena before it was demolished this past summer. Oceanside really gave the defenseman almost like an out or an excuse to put the puck high and use that high flip maneuver, because you get a whistle. You are stuck in your own zone as this one comes in front. It goes behind Chartle's net, now comes right back in front for Cannonberg, and he can't put it home. The defenseman could put it off the ceiling, and if they were stuck in their own defensive zone, they'd get a whistle and a free change and everything. As it comes in front, oh, what a save from Hunter. It was Stepien trying to find the far side of the net, and he got a piece of Hunter's skate along with maybe the post. Milstein gets it in deep. Flynn lays a big hit into the corner. He's going to get penalized for that as the arm comes up from the official, the back official here, who is in his own zone. They're going to call elbowing here against Cooper Flynn. Now, Flynn has a little bit of a tough time against him because he's just taller and bigger than everybody else. He's 6'6", a senior born in 2006. Seen that with Brophy the past 4 years, and well, when he hits people, you can tell, to say the least. And right there you could. So penalty kill for Team Arizona. Tatum will start it at the top for Colorado. They're 0-for-1 on the day. Colorado is on the power play. Tatum across for Adams. Elbowing the call against Flynn. It comes in front side of the net. Shot was blocked by Quinar as he went down to an E. Quinar gets to the wall and clears it all the way down. Engler and Switchenberg back on D with Quinar and Putikov on the PK. Taylor looks to feed the front. Kudakov will go off the wall, but Ward is there for Colorado. And they'll set it up. Back at the blue line, all the way across. Taylor gives it to Tatum. Good puck movement. Shot in front. Shorter with the save. Rebound goes wide. This one cleared. Adams kept it in. Kudakov will take it away. One-on-one the other way. Tries to make a move around his D, who went down and stopped Kudakov's momentum as he did so. 4 minutes into period number two. 2-2 the score as Adams spins at center ice. Switchenberg will take it and whip it all the way down. Cooper Flynn is on that top PK unit for Team Arizona. So Kudakov gets some run here, and now Stepien and Maffeo, the new forward set. Rahela picks off the pass that went away from Stockert and gives it right back. Logan Jackson across for Wilkerson. Stockert plays offside as Ripley was in early, and the puck was caught right at that blue line. 14 seconds to go until Flynn comes out of the box. They'll send out McCaughey and Graham like on the PK. A unit that you don't want to see anyway, and now you see him with a man down. Let's see what they can do. Gramlich just over skates the puck. Wilkerson picks it up and backhands it in. Eirilson takes a big hit behind the net as he collides with the boards. He gets right back up. Flynn comes out of the box. Turnaround shot goes high. Might have got a piece of Schartl's blocker. That's Colorado will take it back with Cannonberg. Jackson to center ice. Stockert couldn't get the touch, icing the call. A choppy start to the second with a lot of whistles and, of course, that penalty that was successfully killed off from Team Arizona. 2-for-2 so far today. After giving up a couple power play goals yesterday, a couple to California. And then Indiana got on the board as well in that first period. Gramlich looks to feed the front. Taken away by Jackson. And through the wall, Colorado exits. Rahela steps up. Couldn't get it past Jackson. Now he's going to have to rush back. Colorado with numbers. Jackson shut off the leg of McCaughey, who is back for Rahela, taking his spot on D as he was rushing back from that pinching attempt. Gramlich gets it ahead. It looked like he didn't even want to do that. He was shaking his head as he saw Ryan Jim coming down the other side. And now Jim has it. Jim in the circle, turns with it, has a power play goal already today. Jim back behind him. Niles will step in. His shot didn't go all the way through, and Jordan comes the other way. Jordan is offside as Gabrick was in a little too early. That was a 3-on-2 potential rush for Colorado that they couldn't make good on. Kane wins it back to Niles. Ahead for Kwinar. At the red, he'll get it to Kane, who slides it in. Barlow for Colorado. Looking at the half wall. Flynn his first shift after taking that elbowing penalty. And I'm sure that hit is in the Team Colorado minds. The defenseman who just went past in Bendico kind of flinched there as Flynn was coming down like a train. Another offside call as Ward just a tick early. It was a very close play at the blue line, but they're going to call it back. It's game 104 for all of Team Arizona. We have Copper and Team Black, the only state that's sending two teams to the Lone Star Showcase here in Dallas. Team Copper 2-0, Team Black 0-1-1. A loss in regulation yesterday to Team Midwest. A 3-2 heartbreaking loss at the end. A goal given up with just over 2 minutes to go. And then lost 2-1 in a shootout in their second game. At the side of the net, wraparound try, and Hunter went from his left to his right well, pushing off the post to get his leg there before Flynn could wrap it all the way around. Barlow takes the hit. Flynn goes right back with the physicality, as he should. Mendico puts it in deep. Niles takes him off the puck. And we're going to have a penalty. Interference is the call. It's going against Team Arizona. And it looks like, yep, Ethan Niles for interference. It was a very close play. You saw it. It looked like Ward was putting the puck in deep. Watch the far side of your screen. And Niles, yeah, he took him down in the corner. That's a fair call and a right one at that. Can always give the forechecker a little bit of a shove. But once he goes down and like that from Ethan Niles, you're going to have the arm come up from the official. So third time to the power play for Team Colorado. Maffeo goes right off the draw and pushes it forward. He stops on a dime, caught up in the snow in front of the Team Arizona bench. Trying to kill some time. Niles in the box for interference. Cannonberg taken to the wall from Switchenberg. This time it hits the net. 2-2, just about halfway through the second period. Stockert, Wilkerson with a big slap shot. It didn't make it to Schottel the first time, and they saw it in front of him and covers. Just 23 seconds gone in the Niles penalty. There hasn't been a ton of shots on net from either side to start, and well, that's relative considering Team Copper had over 40 shots against Team California in game one yesterday. 11 shots for Arizona, 6 shots for Colorado. Stocker turns it over. Maffeo's all alone. His second breakaway on the penalty kill, but he was taken off the puck from Jackson. It was a good play by Jackson coming back and denying that breakaway opportunity. Maffeo doing a good job of killing time as he took it behind the net. Power play halfway done. As Wilkerson puts it across, it comes out to Ripley. Colorado zone entry is struggling here on this power play. Quinar got caught up at neutral as the puck jumped out to him. Stockert on the drop pass, puts it in front looking for Ripley in that bumper position. Now numbers the other way. Quinar couldn't control it. Stockert will hold. Quinar doesn't have a stick. It's basically a 4-on-3 as Quinar can stop the pass across. One more time, and it goes past Wilkerson. Now in the slot, Stockert's shot goes wide. Quinar on the other side. He lays out his man. That's the only thing he can do. He doesn't have a stick as it comes in front. Shot was blocked down by Flynn, and Quinar just swipes it out of the zone from his hand. What a play by Kyle Quinar, and now he heads to the bench. The only thing he could do there was go down to the ice, use his hand, and that's what he did. Adams to the front of the net. Picked off, and here comes Arizona the other way. They have a man deep, and it's Jack Welch on the breakaway. Welch, he scores! What a pass, what a finish, and Jack Welch gets on the board. 3-2, Team Arizona. From one side, with Quinar not having a stick and the power play came to an end, Niles came out. That was an even strength goal from Jack Welch. To the other side, where Welch puts it in the back of the net, over the glove hand of Hunter. Welch with the marker. We'll see who they give assists to. This one goes wide from Ripley. Really good pass from Butler. He broke through Welch, and Butler gets the only assist on this goal from Welch. Colorado looking to come right back. Irelson with a big block. McCorkle taken down in the corner. Penalty upcoming against Team Arizona. That's going to be another hit, and it's going to go against Rahela. Another whistle and another penalty. That's going to be the fourth penalty against Team Arizona. You know, less than 2 minutes, two periods in, I should say. We'll see if it's an elbowing, if it's an interference. We'll get the call from the official now. They're going to say it's a hold, or check that, a roughing. Roughing the call against Rahela, second time to the box for him today. Power play for Team Colorado. They've had every opportunity to get back into this game and really even take the lead. Right now they're down one as Jackson shot, saved from Shortle. Rebound chance goes high by Wilkerson. At the top it's Jackson, he flubs the pass. The other way, Kwinar comes it, trying to get it to Flynn, taking off his stick. A dangerous game that Team Arizona's playing with now four penalties in under two periods. This time it's Rahela. Stockert rims it around. Looking for Barlow, it comes in front. Shardle closes the legs. Rebound to the corner, Jackson keeps it in with his skate. He had the second goal on the power play. Or check that even strength, but from that top blue line as Kwinar will slide it out. Two forwards and Flynn and Kwinar go for a change. And it brings on Kane and Kudakov. Milstein and Niles back on deep. Milstein gives it right back to Jackson at the red. Kane forces him to the boards. Milstein didn't get all that clearing attempt as Kudakov is looking to work it out. He's surrounded by three Colorado forwards. Wilkerson walks out. He shoots. He put it wide to the far post. Two shots from Wilkerson that just missed. Here's another one. Puts it all the way across. Shot goes wide. It was a great pass from Wilkerson to Ripley on the far circle, but couldn't put it in the back of the net as he had Cannenberg as well. Save from Shardle. It goes into the corner. Niles can't get it out. 8 seconds to go in the power play. Niles lays a hit. At the top is Tatum. All the way across, looking for Wilkerson. Kudakov backhands it out. Maybe a two-on-one the other way, but Kane can't control on the pass. You had Rahela coming right out of the box. Went to the bench. McCaughey was coming onto the ice. Icing the call with 2:45 to go in the second. So a successful penalty kill for Team Arizona. That's a perfect PK so far today. Four for four on the PK this morning. As Gramlich will circle the zone, he's at the top, now down to the goal line. Sharp angle try. Where is it? Hunter was looking for it, and it hit the netting. Reed Gramlich so silky with the puck and tried to go over the shoulder of Hunter, and now Colorado has switched their goalies. Cade Kavanaugh is now in net for Colorado. Hunter started out, and they switch to put Kavanaugh in there. It's a different strategy between each team, and no right or wrong way. McCaughey picks up the loose puck at the half wall. It's either do the goalies want to play a full game and flip, you know, one gets the morning, one gets the night game, or do they want to split it right in half where the next whistle after the midway mark through the second, they switch and they both get action in both games each day. Two games Friday, two games today, and one game on Sunday for each team. Now, it'll be two games for Arizona tomorrow because, of course, two teams, Team Copper and Team Black. Switchenberg looking for Jim on the far side, taken away. Gabbert, a good stick right in front of his own bench and enters the zone. And off his stick from Switchenberg, loose puck. Gramlich with speed. Gramlich has Jim to his left to Jim. He shoots. He put it high. Oh, he had an open net. And Ryan Jim just missed his second goal of the game. He pulled it high and now icing the call against Colorado. I want to see if we can get another look at that Jim shot. Gramlich with speed. You see Jim on the left side of your screen. And he had every part of the net to shoot at. What a great look right there on replay. as Jim just put it over the crossbar. It would have been 4-2, Team Arizona. Now 75 seconds to go in period number two. Eirelson jumps up from the blue to keep it in. A dangerous play that stopped the Colorado 2-on-1. Bendico behind his own net with 60 seconds to go in the second period. Kane fighting for it, along with Flynn. Kane gets it low. Colorado looking for a breakaway pass, kept in by Rahela. High slot, bouncing puck. Comes out to neutral. Rahela gives it right back. Icy, 35 seconds. Team Copper, they won their first game against California 6-4. They won their second game yesterday against Indiana 5-2. So two wins by two goals or more. Today looks like a tougher game and only up one. Possibly even fortunate to be up one with how many penalties they've taken. Wall looking for Quinari at 7 seconds. Icing's going to be the call as he can't catch up to it. So they'll drop the puck. One more chance for Colorado before we go to the 1 minute intermission before period number three. Puck drop. It goes to Maffeo. One more try. Cleared out of the zone, and that'll be the end of the second. 3-2 Team Arizona in front. We'll be right back for the final frame. Back here in Dallas for period number three. Just about 20 seconds in as Welch looks to move it in. Turned it over. And it goes back out to Milstein. Right in front of the penalty boxes. Here comes Colorado the other way. Ripley looked to put it across. Taken away, loose puck. Jordan at the blue line, shoots. Boom. Ripley, Stepien, and Welch backhands it out to Maffeo. Haven't seen these three together. And Maffeo looked to put it across. Stepien at the side of the net. Still loose. And Kavanaugh stopped the first and didn't get a second. Puts it down. That's Cade Kavanaugh, the goalie for Colorado. They switched midway through the game. Yes, Logan Hunter had the first. He gave up three. And then Kavanaugh now has the second half of the game. Englert trying to jump in the rush. Englert looks to put it in front. It's a loose side of the net. Who has it? McCaughey tried to put it home. It was right in front of Kavanaugh's pads, and he didn't know where it was, as it was a mad dash to the blue paint. Cole Taylor across, looking for Wilkerson, and he'll get it ahead. Cannonberg drops it. Wilkerson in the circle. His shot saved from Schartle. Schartle's ninth save on 11 shots. Arizona with 15 shots and three goals. So one goal here in the third. Team Arizona has not played a one-goal game in the third so far this weekend. They're always up two or more, and now they're looking for it. Gramlich and Jim, a 2-on-0. Gramlich, forehand, scores! Reed Gramlich, his second goal of the game, both on the breakaway, as he found his way past the defenseman, and he goes on the forehand. Gramlich entered the zone. He saw Jim to his left, pulled it in, and then went right past Kavanaugh to put it in the back of the net. Gramlich's breakaway move is his patented backhand that he scored the first goal with to make it 1-1. And after he scored his goal yesterday on the backhand against California, I went up to him as they give Gramlich a goal, and we'll see if they give any assists.
Hey, Dylan, I'm going to chime in real quick. Sorry, the controller. The center camera controller fell asleep, so I could go wake it up. I'll be just a second.
Two and a half gone here in the third. So going back to that story, Gramlich, who scored the first on the backhand against California yesterday, go up to him, and he tried it again two more times in the game, and the goaltender stopped him. He said, Greed, I know that's your patented move. I know that's what you love to do. Do you have any other moves in your basket? And he said, yeah, I have a little toe drag forehand move. And, well, that's exactly what we saw on that fourth goal from Reed just under 3 minutes in to the third period. The toolbox of Reed Gramlich is full and ready of almost anything you could think of as Jackson's shot goes high and off the netting. Gramlich came in with two goals in two games. He now has two goals in this game to total four on the weekend.
All right, I'm going to get that camera back online. Sorry, we were talking about that netting before. The controller that I use, I have to put a spacer in just to keep that netting off of it. I got caught in it.
It's a low netting here in Dallas as we make our way through. Here's another odd man rush. Jim and Gramlich. Jim for Gramlich for three. Put it high. We went back to the forehand that time. And Gramlich just went high of Kavanaugh's cage. Looking for the hat trick. Now, we mentioned the low glass here and the netting. Well, you'd really have to toss a hat pretty high here in Dallas to get it over and onto the ice. Plus, I don't think the officials would be very happy. They're already here at an early hour. I don't think they want to be cleaning up any hats when they have another game right after this one, which is another Team Arizona game. It's not Team Copper, it's Team Black. And they'll be taking on Team Washington. We'll have it right here on the OSHA YouTube page. Just a different link, so go back to our page and you can watch Team Black. Jim enters the zone, looking for Borchardt. McCaughey keeps it in to Eirilson. Down low for Jim to Gramlich. Gramlich at the line, back in front. And did it go in? Yes, it did. What a feed from Gramlich to Stepien. Parker Stepien gets his first goal of the weekend and a three-goal lead for Team Arizona. You see Gramlich come down the wall. It was really all set up at the wall from Eirilson. Gramlich goes down low, and an easy tap-in from Stepien as Kavanaugh had to go from his left to his right. So Parker Stepien gets on the board, and he gets his first goal of the weekend to make it 5-2. We mentioned it, Team Arizona has not played a lot of close games in the third period. Well, they have made this game now a three-goal game. Welch across in front. Puck goes wide. The goal here was announced that Gramlich gets it. That's not correct, as you saw on the replay. Stepien put in the back of the net as this one goes across. So hopefully they fix that. Well, we know the real answer. That Stepien got it. Although Gramlich would probably take the hat trick if you gave it to him, as any player would. Stepien did a good job of getting in that slot and finishing off a great passing play. Caught up in the slot, still loose, and Welch can't backhand it home. Picks it up, going down low for Butler. Looking for Stepien, all the way across Niles. He drags, he shoots, it went wide. Kwinar gets it low, and out comes Team Colorado. In the corner is Stockert, under 9 minutes now in the third. 18-13 shots in favor of Team AZ with a 2-0 third period. Adam shoots, save, rebound, gets cleared out. That was Tatum from the blue. Caught up in that corner. Some more physicality now as the ice tightens up. Three-goal lead to defend. Wilkerson comes in front. Stockert shot from a sharp angle. Got blocked. Now behind the net. Chartle looking to keep his legs on both posts. Stockert still with it behind the net. This has been the best line for Team Colorado today. Easily as it goes in the back of the net. Chartle can't hold it. And it's put in from Team Colorado. A goal they really needed to get back into this one. And they get it to make it a two-goal game. We'll see who they give it to. It was right at the side of the net. Cannonberg's going to get it, his second goal of the game. As Chartle couldn't control. And Steven Cannonberg gets his second. He makes it 5-3. It's been a lot of quick strike offense today from both sides, and you can see it on that shift. When one team scores, the other team usually comes right back 4-1. Kwinar on the forecheck. We're going to get a whistle as the helmet comes off of Adams. Or check that, Tatum. The helmet came off, and he looked right at the official like, why are you blowing the whistle? Well, it's for your safety. And we don't want anything happening without your helmet going on. It's a dangerous game out there. That's why I feel safe behind the netting here. If there was no netting, I might have to wear a helmet myself. And, well, definitely get a couple names wrong if I was wearing a helmet. Kane goes across. Jordan looking to backhand it on the half wall. He does. He pushes it forward. And a big hit along the wall forces the puck out of play. Past the halfway mark here in the third. Today's schedule.